Recently, the kind folks at Alpha Model decided to send over two of their beautiful custom resin models for me to review for you guys. So we're going to be taking these out of the box, taking a look at all the parts. I don't have time to actually build these. These are highly complicated kits. These are definite take your time. It's going to take maybe even a couple of weeks if you're a fast builder. You want to make sure you do a great job because these kits are not inexpensive, but they are absolutely beautiful. Rare, limited production runs. Once they're done, and they move on to the next kit. So the first one we're going to pull out is the sweet 1/24th scale McLaren 720S. When you go to Alpha Model and you want to pick this one up, it's catalog number AM020014. You can get them all from Alpha Model direct. They'll ship them from overseas and they actually arrive quite quickly and in excellent condition. They are packed absolutely beautifully. These are all resin kits, so you will need epoxy and you will need super glue to put these parts together. Model glue does not work on resin model kits. Look at these parts, which we're going to be showing off. Look at the dashboard. Look at the detail. These resin kits always amaze me. Molded in this nice off tan, will accept primer beautifully. Just the level of detail. And I will have some slideshow at the end. Look at the vents on there. Deep molding. Resin casting, it kind of fills in the cavity. They can get a lot of finer details you would never see with precision injection molding, though injection molding is catching up these days. Look at that spoiler and how thin it is. You can see through it. You can see through the back because it's so thin and to scale. Resin can be a little brittle, so don't crack it. We've got some what looks like possible brake discs here, or backing to brake discs. We've got the cockpit. On these sports cars, I always call it the cockpit because these things are like jets with tires on the ground. Nice thick lugs on these. The kit has a very weighty feel to it. It has the weight of a die cast, but it's all resin. Here's the underbody. This is a curbside kit for the McLaren. There is no full engine detail. We'll get out some of the smaller parts. Then we're going to bring out that body and blow your mind away. We got door panels, door panel inserts, more door panel inserts. The door panels are three parts on this car. We got two-part seats, which are exquisite. We got the interior, exterior door panels. Check out the mirrors and the sport steering wheel with that oval shape to it. Look at these vents. Molded completely open. Beautifully in scale, not too thick. Check out that. That looks like it's for molding photo etch is what I'm guessing it is. We've got exhaust tips, more molding and vents here. Look at these things. So tiny, crisp, beautiful. Look at the calipers. There's one that fell off that tree. The brake calipers are even molded open where they should be open. They are outstanding. Here's one off the tree. When you cut resin, make sure you wear a ventilator if you're going to be sanding on it. You can clip it and shave it. Look at that center console. Old TV screen there, little touch screen. So many tiny, thin, little, beautiful parts here. So let's get to the seats. There's your seat back and seat bottom. That's just begging for paint, panel washes, little highlighting with some Gundam markers. If you've never seen a Gundam marker, it's a very fine line marker. Molotow black line markers, perfect for getting inside there and detailing those pieces and parts. Here we've got exterior door panel. Turn it around, we've got our interior door panels. And then we've got the door mechanism panel, the actual insert with the handles and all the beautiful panel lines. Awesome. I can't get over how model making is advanced. Check out that diffuser. All right, then we've got, I don't even know what these parts are, but they're cool looking. Standoffs for something, possible wheel mounting, axle ends. Now, that's one giant, how did they even cast that? I don't know. I have no idea how they cast this. Because they've got inserts, they've got bars across there. These got to be pressure molded. I mean, look at that. That is outstanding. You can see where the doors are going to go on, so that they're a separate piece, so you get that large separation line where you should. The nose on that beauty, it's one giant lug of resin. I don't see any pinholes. I don't see air bubbles. I don't see short shots on there. Exquisite. And they must be checking these out too before they ship them. So you definitely get what you pay for in the size of that. We're not even done. There's more multimedia accessories on the other side. We've got some screws to aid assembly, included in little bags, bagged up individually, rubber tires mounted on the gorgeous McLaren wheels, all the way open, beautiful tread pattern. You get fats and skinnies, though, on these cars. But, I mean, look at even the tread pattern on that. Amazing. Love these. I can't wait to look at the other one. You get one, two, three, four photo etch frets, brake discs, probably to go on either side of those resin discs we saw. We've got window frames. These have a clear plastic on them, so you can actually cut on them. Get the parts out without it going disappearing. Look at this. Just beautiful. And looks like done in steel instead of brass. We've got even thinner. These are thinner than paper. Little holes in them. This is what I think this mold over here is for. Reach across to shape this part to the proper way. You would place that part in there. You would take this half and press it down and clamp it, and it will bend this grill to the appropriate shape. We've got another etch. Logos. Just wonderful. Mirrors, reflective surfaces. Still not done. We've got really delicate clear resin parts for the lighting. So you can color these with your Tamiya clears. They won't melt. They won't fracture. Glue them in place with Mod Podge gloss. Here we've got some reflective badging done as decals that you can put on for the mirrors. Company logos. You cut each one out and apply it and rub it onto the surface. We've got two small waterslide decal sets, gauge clusters, callouts, looks like center caps, even the tiniest little lettering in waterslide. What else we got? We got the glass. This is actually a pushout. It's been like die cut. You can see around the non-colored ones. You will push those out. You'll remove the protective film that's over the top, and then you will attach these in place. All pre-painted, ready to go with the glass, and it forms easily. See how it's adhesive like that? So they can die cut it. How cool is that? That's everything that's in the McLaren 720S. Next up, I will pull out the Ferrari Pista. Next up, we'll go right into the Ferrari 488 Pista 1/24th scale. When you want to pick this one up from Alpha Model, catalog AM02 0010 builds this gorgeous Italian stallion from Alpha Model, of course. These come packed absolutely. I've never seen a kit packed as well, aside from the Dodge Ram resin kit from that company as well for overseas shipping, was packed exquisitely, and so are these. Everything's protected with its own foam and with its own plastic baggies and all of that. So let's start taking a look at some of these mini parts now on this one, because on the real Ferrari, you can see parts of the engine. You'll be able to see them on the kit too. So get out those metal paints and get ready to start having fun. We got some hoses and lines right there. Check out the dashboard on the Ferrari. Street legal race cars is all Ferraris are. McLarens, exotics, and that's what Alpha deals in, is all these amazing exotics. They put out a ton of different kits. By the time this video is out, they'll have numerous other kits available. I don't know how they get them done so fast, but they, look at that, engine parts. They sure get them out quickly and beautifully. They make all these molds and design them by direct from them, so you know you're getting the official kits, not copies of copies. Look at that diffuser for the back of the car. That's all anyone ever sees when they're near a Ferrari anyways, is the back end of it. So you got to make it look cool. Got another door panel here. We got more parts of the dashboard since it's so complicated. I think anyone ever put, they probably put like these cool calf skin leather gloves in there when they own a Ferrari. Look at that console. Cup holders, shifters, all the cool ejection seat buttons. All Ferraris have ejection seats. You just have to hit something doing 200 miles an hour, you'll see. More door panel detail, interior panels. Check out the steering box on this. Look at that steering wheel. Even the rear view mirror is a cast work of art. Finally done. Different console pieces. Okay, let's get some of this other stuff. Because you're gonna be, you thought the detail on the other one was great, and it was. It was phenomenal. This one, Ferraris are luxury exotic cars, so they're a little fancier and you can see more. McLarens are just like, let's just go super crazy fast. Look at that engine detail on there. Those must be little individual coils. Look at the seats, the backs and the seat. How lovely the mirrors on that thing. Like I said, you're not noticing any short shots. You're not noticing any pin marks or air bubbles. That's how you can tell it was the first run. They don't sit and use their molds forever so that they become absolutely poor and go, so what? They run a few and they're done. So if you want something from Alpha Model, get it. Look at that. I mean, there's little vents in there. Amazing. Nothing's broken. Nothing's cracked. And resin can be brittle. Look at the calipers on that. Is that crazy? That is so cool. They look like little hockey masks or little lacrosse nets. More engine parts. We saw the other cylinder head. We got more engine detail on this one because you'll be able to see the engine through the big rear window. Look at the pedals. Molded open. Awesome. Look at that. That is just so cool. We got those large brake discs as well. So we're going to have photo etch. We've got the bottom of the chassis to smooth it out, down going through the wind. Little diffusers, all the panel lines, screw holes, everything are correct. Check out the interior tub. Two-piece interior tub. These parts don't really need a bunch of cleanup. You just want to soak them in degreaser. Or a mild, like a dish detergent. You don't want to melt your resin parts. Look at that, under the bonnet. Insane, we got the tub for the interior. A two-seater race car, you can see the bottom. And again, huge, heavy slug of resin for that body. Oh, look at the molding detail on there. Got for the badges, insets, you know exactly where to put them. All the vents that we saw molded. The back end. That is just phenomenal. Excellent work, Alpha Model. Let's look at all the multimedia for the kit. We've got our no-name tires, super low profile, Ferrari wheels, extremely thin molded. Got the little lugs in there and everything. The tread on those is beautiful. The interior. And we got the little wider in the rear. Awesome tread pattern, super low sidewall, just like the real thing. You get a nice set of those bagged up. You get two aluminum exhaust tips. That's sweet little black wash inside there. They look every bit the part. You've got some blow molded plastic for like the headlights or the side lights. Now we've got one, two, three, four photo etch trees. We've got the reflective surfaces again and the logos. You've seen decals like this in Tamiya. They work quite well for reflective surfaces. We got a bag of screws for final assemblies. We've got the first set of photo etch with the plastic film to let you cut on it without them flying everywhere. So these must build up in layers for brake discs, so that they're like a vented disc on the inside with the slotted rotor on the outside. We got all the grill vents. We've got the paddle shifters for the steering wheel. Give yourself a good amount of time to build one of these guys, but you will enjoy yourself. We've got some badging here, seat belts. Badging, you can make your own seat belts. And the last tree is more small grills and other badging. Then we've got a beautiful waterslide decal set. Very large sheet on this one because you have multiple painting options with this car. Got small logos, got speedometer, Ferrari logos, all the striping you could ever want for all the different logos and interior and exterior paint schemes. We've got those self-adhesive push-out windows again. You can see they just start to peel out. All done for you. Don't have to mask those off. Don't have to paint them. And at this price level, that is excellent. All companies should be doing that at that price level, making life easier on you. And since we didn't show it in the last one, these are how nice their manuals are. They're large sheets of paper, printed in color, tell you exactly what parts to grab, photo etch parts, tells you photo etch, photo etch, photo etch, decal, decal with a D, PE, where to put them, how to put them. There is no mistaking exactly where everything goes. There's your final assembly drawings. You can hang these up. They're their own little works of art to begin with. Yeah, see, they assemble in the center like that, so you can have the vented disc. And then all your different paint schemes, color options, stuff like that. So these are exquisite kits. I'm gonna have some still shots of the parts so you can get a good look at them sitting still at the end of the video. Thanks for watching the workshop. Thanks to Alpha Model for sending these over all the way from the land of the rising sun. They arrived in beautiful condition and took less than a few weeks to get here. They sent them over air miles, so you can expect the same kind of service when you order yours. We'll see you at the next review. Notte, giorno, di torno, girano, delle belle turbando al riposo, ma ci sei tua dolcino d'amor. Delle belle turbando al riposo, ma ci sei tua dolcino d'amor. Non più avrai questi bei panacchini, quel cappello leggero galante, quella chioma, quell'aria brillante, quel vermiglio d'onesco color, quel vermiglio d'onesco color. Non
più vrai, quei pennacchini, quel cappello, quella chioma, quell'aria brillante. Non chiudrai farfalloni amoroso, notte giorno di torno girando.